Out of all the Lil rappers out there, my favorite would have to be Lil B the Bass God. But Lil Uzi has also really grown on me with his mixtapes, taking off on Bad and Bougie, and now with his first official album that I would say is some of his best stuff. But of course, the standard has become that if you appreciate real rap in any way, shape, or form, you're not supposed to be listening to this mumble rapple jumbo. But let me explain. Because I think that you can take a step back and understand what good lyrics are and realize that, yeah, half of what Uzi says needs subtitles and picture cards, but this new wave, this new movement has something going for it. There has to be a reason why these guys are blowing up and hitting the charts, and if I can take the time to break down and appreciate the parts that work in some of today's dumbest movies, then I also want to dig deep and understand what makes Lil Uzi Vert the artist that he is. So for starters, when I first heard him, I legit this dude sounded like Kel if they replaced all of his orange soda with lean. This was a dude with crazy colored hair, face tats, piercings, was clearly inspired by anime and rock music, and had one of the most careless flows I've ever heard. And then I found out this was him in 2014.
I don't smoke no weed, but your shit smell like me. Demons in me, mixed breed, and heaven sent. And I'm screaming steak town till Jesus come back. And I hit you with the Uzi, diamond toe in that mat.
So how does someone go from sounding like your standard Philly rapper to this easy breezy colorful rock? Then it hit me. Pretty much every rapper out there has an onomatopoeia that they spit out like their Pokemon. Gucci's always cold, Chance likes to squeak, Wayne likes to laugh, and Kanye's always confused. And there's a bunch of other artists who have specific rap phrases that become their thing, what they're known for. And I think that's important because it not only creates their image, builds their fan base, but in the year of the meme, it helps a lot of people who wouldn't know them, kind of laugh at them, but know of their existence. Because once people can pinpoint something about you or label you in some way, they tend to remember you. Once Uzi got his distinct look, he stood out. Once he changed his flow, he started making money. But the thing is that it has to go beyond just switching up your style and becoming crazy, because any person can do that. Any person can dress differently, and that doesn't mean it's gonna stick. The key is in living. He doesn't just have a careless flow, he has a careless lifestyle. Always living in the moment, jumping off stages, overall not caring what anybody thinks about him. All that dying and joining the 27 Club, I think is all for attention. The whole devil worshipping stuff, I believe is a way to get people to continue to talk about him the same way that people pretend to be Christian to get support. But while this whole aesthetic shift was a genius move in order to get noticed, it was his energy that really caught my attention. Again, I'm not saying that I love all of his tracks, I'm definitely not saying he's the lyricist of this generation, because that would be Lil Pump, but what he does carry with him is emotion. There was a video featuring a linguist who broke down how you may not understand a word Young Thug says, but you can feel it in the way that he shifts his tones. Again, I know to some this isn't something they can ever connect with because they prefer the English language, but the more and more that I heard these new wave of artists, the more that I would listen to what they were trying to say, listen to their style, see how they've blown up and gained an audience, I kinda got it. The approach of show don't tell in their music, of not wanting to overproduce something in fear of losing that initial vibe that they had. It's a style I don't expect everyone to love, and there will always be those instances where you can point out someone and be like, you're just riding on this wave because you're untalented and lazy. But I don't think that's the case with Uzi. He may be random, but he is telling a story. Throughout his mixtapes, for example, you follow him through the relationship with his girlfriend Brittany, who's not only been the main influence with his fashion, but someone he consistently brings out on stage. So in Love is Rage, the first album that he has, we hear him fall in love with the girl, with the title itself being an acronym for his name, as he's raging for her. In the follow-up, which paid homage to Scott Pilgrim, Uzi goes to get the girl, with songs like P's and Q's talking about how he fought off ex-boyfriends for her. In the Perfect Love tape, he gets the girl, but as we saw with the EP and the biggest single that he has, it all leads to the breakup album based on his ex, which is Love is Rage 2. He may not write anything down and just goes into the booth and records off the dome, which, again, produces a lot of dumb stuff, but he manages to express how he really feels with that freedom. And that leads to the thing I like the most about him. He turns depressing songs into straight-up bangers. Mike Posner made a song where he vented about being a failure, falling into peer pressure, and how he was a one-hit wonder with no hope. They then made that into a house remix, and people partied to that 24/7. XL Tour Life similarly was recorded while he was on tour with The Weeknd and his XL label. Not only was it a morbid reflection of how lonely fame could be, how he was dealing with a breakup, but it also was considered the song of the summer. And there's several songs on the new album that does that, where he is actually speaking English, but he's portraying something more, and it's just masked over a catchy beat, where he's stating how he feels about his ex-girlfriend, his mother, the fame that he feels isn't worth it, and a bunch of other addictions. But again, they're all masked by his antics. So yeah, while Lil Uzi Vert may not be for everyone, you can't ignore his following. You can't ignore how he was able to turn himself into one of the biggest artists today by using this meme rap, this mumble rap, this new wave of artists that are out there that are all about emotion. Because even though this dude may be mumbling, fact is, people are listening. Thank you.